plays with.
Klay Thompson has been sensational.
I know we've said this many times before, but I'll say it again. He had a great first half, just an explosive offensive display there.
At the end of the day, I wouldn't be surprised if we're talking about what a great second half he had. He can usually keep it going for all four quarters.
Look at this.
Heinrich and Rose, the guards. Gibson is the four with Gasol in the middle.
Bitch, can you look up?
The small forward. That's the five out there for the Bulls. Lots of room.
LeBron
gets the front of the rim and out.
Go!
Last season, Andrew Bogut was able to say that he was the healthiest he's been in years. And that might not seem like much, but it makes a huge difference for him to be at full strength.
Little bitch.
The kick out to Rose. And it's out from three-point range. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
They got right to the rim, but got hammered once he got there by the defense.
And that was a nice job taking it strong and forcing his way to the line. Well done.
And he can't hit the second.
Get the shit out of here.
People knew that he could shoot the ball coming out of college, but I don't think teams knew that Klay Thompson would develop into the dead-eye shooter that he's become. He is a flat-out laser, and he can go to get into zones where he just doesn't miss, whether he's open or well guarded. Got a good look, though. I thought that was going to go down.
Now, the Dean may have done just enough there, Clark, to bother him.
Gasol dishes the Rose. Hits it from three-point range.
That's safe.
Rose has got the lead up to four now for the Bulls.
That was simply a defensive breakdown there, Kevin. He was all
with Klay, you know not every team thought of him as an elite shooter,
right,
or he wouldn't have gone as late as he did in the draft. But with his size, he has incredible range, and that has proved to be a factor in his play.
Man, one thing he's been able to do this season is find ways to quicken that release. And now he can get that three off in the blink of an eye. He's a big, strong kid. And doesn't need much room at all to let it fly. So what an incredible weapon to have on offense.
And Steph Curry with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group. Miritich is checked in for Gibson. Tony Snell comes in for Jimmy Butler. Morris checked in for Kirk Heinrich. And it's Brooks in for Derrick Rose. The Warriors making a switch here. Green's checked in.
That's his first personal foul.
Here is Brooks. This is his first free throw of the game.
When you look back at last season, he shot 87% from the foul line.
You know, he really did excel at the stripe. I mean, they couldn't have asked for too much more from him when it came to knocking down free throws. You know that old saying, the more things change, the more things stay the same. That applies to Chicago. Once again, they were incredibly tough at home with their defense.
Last break, here comes Chicago. Moore is running.
Their advantage, guys starting to climb a little bit. Things are coming together for them. At a great time.
They don't want to let it get too late to increase that lead. Best to do it here in the third.
And the Warriors miss again. And that tough defense by the Bulls here in Chicago, Steve, helped them to 27 wins in the United Center.
Well, tough defense can stifle a lot of teams, and the Bulls have that for sure. That's been the strength of their club for a long time. And when you add that to this kind of home court advantage, it's a pretty tough combination to beat.
Oh, my God.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Burke.
Hey, Kevin, well, Kirk Heinrich signing a deal to stay in Chicago. He said, I grew up a Bull in this league and will always think of myself as a Chicago Bull. Guys, his scrappy game is very much appreciated. As Taj Gibson has said, he's one of the toughest guys I know. He doesn't shy away from anything. He's one of those dark players. Back to you.
A great fit in their defensive system. Heinrich accepts the challenge every single night.
Now you're happy, right?
And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here. And some changes here for the Warriors. McAdoo comes in for Draymond Green. And Steph Curry subbed in for Sean Livingston. No nobody near Barnes. And no good. The try spell continuing for him.
An 8-rebound advantage like what we have now is always going to swing the score hard in that team's direction.
And that's certainly been the case today. Their rebounding has made a huge difference.
Boy, bet you want to play like LeBron James.
Shoots the three. And it will go, and the Bulls' lead is cut to just 11 on the basket from Stephen Curry.
Second three-pointer of the half.
Excellent ball movement guys.
Yeah, I think that's what's keyed this run, Clark, Steph Curry, because they're keeping the ball moving. Defense hasn't been able to set up.
There's the three. Chicago grabs the miss.
Really? Shit!
Here's the floater. Can't connect. And as we...
What?
The Bulls leading by 14. So for the Golden State Warriors right now, Thompson and Barnes, the 2
my
and
God,
3. Maurice Spates out there with McAdoo. And it's Curry in at the 5.
Harrison Barnes.
Nobody near Barnes. From beyond the arc and then some. Barnes has got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Warriors. And it's Rose penetrating and stolen by Barnes.
He is garbage.
Fires the three. Another three for Golden State.
Now that's like a layup for him. He's just wide open out there.
I'm so bitch!
Somehow ignores the tight D and gets the layup.
And what jumps out at you guys, the assist. Dominant in that category. It's the ball movement, the player movement, great rhythm to their offense.
Clearly seems to me a different mindset between these teams.
See the defense get caught standing around that time, giving up an easy second chance bucket.
Simply need more of an effort on the boards there, Steve.
Chicago calls timeout.
Maurice Spates, a big man with a nice shooting touch. Last season, an uptick in three-point attempts for him.
That
might be a good move to go for a shot outside the arc. The three and the way the game is played now is much more valuable than the long two-point shot.
Andrew Bogut, he's checked in for McAdoo.
Maybe so.
Doris Burke has some information for
really
us, Doris.
Really?
Hi, guys. Over that break, I was able to catch the message Tom Thibodeau was giving to his team. He told the players, let's put our foot on them and keep them down. We've got them exactly where we want them. I want to see you guys slow the pace, use the clock, and stay away from any silly fouls.
Thanks, Doris. And Mo Spates, a backup big for Florida during their second NCAA title in 07.
And he declared for the draft in 2008. He's taken 16th overall. He's been a solid rotation player throughout his career.
How come I can't fucking do it to you, bro?
He can probably improve a little bit defensively. But offensively, he's got the ability to score out there, both inside and out.
Hodge Gibson, in his sixth season now in the NBA, he's in the prime of his career at 29 years old. Last season, he upped his
scoring
and averaged double digits for the first time in his career.
Bitch, fool.
And the Warriors making a change here. McAdoo's checked in.
Even though he isn't having the best of games from the floor, it hasn't seemed to hurt him.
Cannot hit. So the Bulls will take it the other way. They've led by as many as 14 points.
I swear to God.
And for Gibson, becoming more efficient. More free throw attempts and a big leap, guys, in his free throw percentage. Steve cracking 70% from the line for the first time.
He was by far his best performance offensively, Kevin. He came into his own in terms of his post play. I think he just believed in his own mind and his own heart that he was now a good offensive player. And that's the case, no question.
Warriors trail by 9. Curry, wide open. Another three for Golden State.
You know, the more these three-pointers continue to drop, the more you can sense the frustration coming from this defense.
Bitch.
No question. No matter what they're throwing at them, they've not been able to take that shot away.
Boy, such standing patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Yeah, absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding. They are piling up the assists.
David Lee's checked in for the Warriors.
Nigga, stop fouling me, boy.
On its way from Curry for two. It's all the Warriors. Gibson's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game.
Yeah. A real difficult game for him offensively, and it's costly. Boy, they needed that last rebound. They haven't done well on the boards overall, but that one was huge.
Still fighting for the win. Make that blackout, bitch.
Chicago leading by 8.
Okay, I hate fucking
the now the feed to Rose. Heinrich outside.
Oh my god.
That's the free fly.
You white fucker!
It's good. This time the assist from Rose.
Yeah, you like his shot selection today. He set a good example for the rest of his teammates. This quarter has not been his best. The defense may be starting to affect him a little bit.
He with the ball. Here's McAdoo. A three-pointer off the mark. But they get it back. Thompson for 3. And he gets it to go.
Wow, this fourth quarter has just been tremendous for them for good.
Yeah, they're locked in and putting up a ton of points from outside.
Get the fuck out, nigga!
Stolen by Thompson. Fires from deep. Connects! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
Well, you know, he
come on, I got no guy! No, fuck you!
And that's why we're looking at this result so far. And with that basket, you'd have to think this lead
Steph Curry
is safe.
Well, if not 100% safe, certainly 95%.
That's demoralizing. They needed a stop there, and instead, they give up 3 points on an open look.
And he commits the intentional foul. Raymond Green, who's checked in for Curry. And here we go. Warriors running again. Out to Lee. From the wing.
No!
He shot that one, missing.
I'm stupid!
And now they decide to foul intentionally.
I'm done.
He drops the first one. That puts them up by 5. The Warriors making a switch here. Barnes has checked in.
Oh.
And so he drops them both. It's a 6-point ball game.
Good work at the line to stretch that lead out.
Come on, boy, you got this.
Urgent possession here, Clark. They need a basket.
No doubt about it, Steve. They need quick, efficient scoring.
You know what? They've been relying on his 3-point shot all game long, and he has not let them down.
They need a few more of them if they're going to pull this game out. He can't
stop.
But you do what you have to do to extend this game and try to get the ball back.
In this situation, clock management crucial.
And a tough break is his second attempt at the line. No good. Thompson for the triple. And that'll be Golden State as it goes out of bounds. Warriors retain possession.
Come on, bro.
There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's McAdoo. They grab their own miss. Lee passes to Barnes. It falls.
And another.
You fucking bitch! Good job, bro. Good job. We've not yet lost all our graces. No, nigga. The hounds will stay in shape. All right, fine. Nice, bro. You have to beat me by 1 point, fucking faggot. Good job, bro. Damn, I'm surprised I made that 3, but you won by 1 fucking point! Fucking faggot.